Assalamu alaikum, dear students. This is me, Atiq Ahmed. Today we are going to study two organelles, the vacuole and the lysosome. We will start from the first organelle, that is the vacuole. Vacuole is basically a fluid-filled sac which is covered by a single membrane known as tonoplast. Vacuole is basically a small organelle and it contains fluid inside, and it is covered by a single membrane which is known as tonoplast. Now we have already studied in the previous lectures that there are certain organelles which are covered by double membrane. Still there are certain organelles which are covered by single membrane, and still there are certain organelles which are even not covered by any membrane. For example, those which are covered by a double membrane, for example chloroplast, for example nucleus, for example mitochondria, these are covered by a double membrane. Those which are covered by single membrane, for example endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, and similarly the vacuole, this is also a single membrane bound organelle. But still there is one unique organelle which is not covered by any membrane, and that is the ribosome. So vacuole is an organelle which is covered by a single membrane. Now eukaryotic cells basically contain vacuoles. There may be one vacuole or there may be many vacuoles depending on the cell. For example, mature plant cell have just one vacuole, and that is the central vacuole. On the other hand, the animal cells, they have several vacuoles. Similarly, the various protist cells, they also have vacuoles, and usually few in number. We will move towards the teaching points. Now there are four types of vacuoles which are based on cells and their functions. Those vacuoles which are found in animal cells are called animal vacuoles, because they are found in animals. So the vacuoles which are found in animal cells, those are usually small in size, but they are more in number per cell. In animals, there are small vacuoles and many in number per cell. In mature plant cells, the small vacuoles fuse together to form one large central vacuole. That is a large vacuole in case of plants, and it occupies the center of the cell. So the other organelles are pushed towards the periphery. So in case of plant cells, in the center, you people have remembered, we have studied it, that in the plant cells, in the center, there is vacuole, there is no nucleus. While in animal cells, the central area is occupied by the nucleus. So in plant cells, there is one central large vacuole. Now that vacuole is basically filled by water, salts, and other materials. Now these materials basically swell the vacuole. As a result, the vacuole push the other content of the cells toward the cell wall, and as a result the plant cell become turgid, hard. So this is one of the reason due to which the plant cells are hard, that they have vacuoles, large central vacuole, and that has filled inside with water, salts, and other materials. Now another category of vacuole which we are going to study, that is the food vacuole. The food vacuoles are usually found in the protist cell. For example, in amoeba, the food vacuole is found, and these vacuoles are basically used to capture the food from the surrounding water. So these organisms, usually protists, they take in food material from the outside in the form of food vacuoles. And these food vacuoles are then brought inside, and then the food is digested. So these are called food vacuoles. Now some unicellular organisms excrete waste material by packing them in a contractile vacuole. This is another type of vacuole. So in protist cell, usually in amoeba, in paramecium, etc. The contractile vacuoles are found, and these contractile vacuoles are used to excrete out the waste materials from the cell. So the waste materials which are produced as a result of various metabolic processes, those are packed in a small vacuole and that is then pushed outside the cell. Before proceeding towards the lysosome, we will have a diagrammatic look over the vacuole. This is the vacuole, this is the plant cell. Remember, this shape is basically the plant. This plant cell has this large central vacuole. This is known as central vacuole. This, and this is this is basically the membrane of this vacuole, which is known as tonoplast. So this is the plant vacuole. This is found in plant. Another vacuole, this is lytic vacuole. Lytic means breakdown. It is used for the breakdown of various materials. Now we will move towards the second organelle, the lysosome. Lysosome is covered by a single membrane. This is again a single membrane organelle. It is covered by a single membrane and it contains digestive enzyme, very strong digestive enzymes. Digestive enzymes are used to digest a food, to break down the various food contents. For example, proteins are broken down by proteases. So proteases are digestive enzymes. Similarly, lipids are broken down by lipases. So lipases are digestive enzymes. Similarly, the carbohydrates are broken down by amylases. So amylases are digestive enzymes. So lysosome is covered by a single membrane. It is a small organelle covered by a single membrane and it contains strong digestive enzymes which are used for the digestion of food materials and other waste material. Lysosome break down food and waste material within the cells because they contain the digestive enzymes we have already discussed. So the lysosome fused with the vacuole, for example food vacuole, that contain the food material and then digest the food material through its strong digestive enzymes. Now usually how lysosome works, what is the mechanism of lysosome working? So lysosome basically fuses with the food vacuole. The food vacuole contains the food, so the lysosome fuses with the food vacuole and the digestive enzyme which is found inside the lysosome, those are used to break down the food which is found in the food vacuole. And whenever this process of digestion is completed, so then the waste material which is produced during the process of digestion, that is packed in another vacuole which is known as contractile vacuole, which we have studied in the previous topic above. So the waste materials are excreted out from the cell through contractile vacuole. Now this is lysosome. This is diagrammatic representation. This is lysosome. There is another example of lysosome. Again, this is lysosome. So these are the other cell organelles. So normally, usually what happens usually that inside the food vacuole, the food is brought inside. That food vacuole is fused with this lysosome, and the digestive enzyme which are found inside the lysosome, those digestive enzyme break down the food material. As a result, the small particles which are produced as a result of digestion, those are absorbed inside the cell and the waste materials are packed into another vacuole which is called contractile vacuole, and through contractile vacuole the waste material are excreted out from the body to the outside environment. That's all about today's lecture. Inshallah, see you with a new lecture next time. Take care. Allah Hafiz.